So I'm here at Starbucks today. It's a cold winter day. I figure I'd go in and get something good. And one thing about Starbucks that I think about is the smell. Man, when you go in that place, it just smells good. One of the things that we're learning in this book that we read is the temple worship and the tabernacle worship and had a lot of smell. Some of them good, like the fat being burnt on the altar, the fat offerings, and then some of them bad and disgusting, like the offal and the just the sacrifice of the dead animals and the entrails and all that going around. But I want to go inside. Let's talk a little bit more about smells today as we look at the laver. It smells good in here. I can't even tell you how good it smells. But you know, let's face it, sometimes we all stink a little. That morning shower that we take, it only lasts so long. And have you ever had the experience of being around someone stinky in public? And it's not the most pleasant thing in the world, but what stinks more than that is when you're the stinky one. I remember one time when I was on an airplane ride, a long, long ride, going across the ocean, and I began to complain to a friend of mine on the plane. I went to his chair and I said, you know, this guy next to me just reeks. He stinks. And I went back, and man, it was the longest flight ever, and I just had to smell this guy forever while we were on this airplane. And then we got off the plane and we're over at baggage claim, and I can still smell the smell. And pretty soon I took a whiff, and sure enough, it wasn't him. You ever had that experience? You know, sometimes we can just be nose blind. And it's a term my kids like to use a lot of times. And spiritually, I think we can be nose blind. Have you ever been lulled into thinking spiritually that you're set? That it was kind of a once and done thing, and your ticket is stamped, and you kind of go about not really considering the idea that you might need more than just one bath to get it done. In Revelation chapter 3, verse 17, God's talking to the church at Laodicea, and He's telling them, you know, that they're lukewarm, and why it is that they're lukewarm. And he says this verse to them, which I always thought was really interesting. He says, you think, or you say, I am rich, I have acquired wealth and do not need a thing. And so basically they're saying, we're not stinky. But God looks at them and says, but you do not realize that you are wretched, pitiful, poor, blind, and naked. They had become spiritually nose blind. And so if the spiritual wash basin, the laver that you and I wash in, is the Word of God, what must we smell like when we haven't been in the laver for a while? And so God goes on to say, I counsel you to buy from me gold refined in the fire so that you can become rich, and white clothes to wear so you can cover your shameful nakedness, and salve to put on your eyes so that you can see. And the way we wash in the Word is just by spending time in it. And as we're looking at the progression of the worship at the temple, we started with the door or the gate, and Jesus is the way through that gate, and we approach the altar where there's an altar of sacrifice and our sin is taken care of. But then we move into a more, we're moving closer and closer towards intimacy, and we come to the laver, this wash basin. And I have to ask myself, who uses the laver? Well, the answer is kind of explained in the book. It says those who are forgiven of their sins, who have gone past the altar and made the sacrifice and confessed their sins. But it's also only for priests. And one thing I really like about this book that's brought out for us is the consideration that we are all in the New Testament priests. We call that the priesthood of all believers. And so it's necessary for you and me to be cleansed by the Word on a daily basis. If not, we go nose blind. And let me ask you a question. Do you consider, do you think that you could possibly today be nose blind to your own spiritual stink? Janice at church, she has a phrase that I like to use now. I stole it from her. She talks about your word level. What's your word level? Are you in the Word enough to be clean? I know when we're teaching our kids to bathe on their own, you know, sometimes they just jump in and jump out, or sometimes they just play in the tub and they never really get to washing anything, and so you got to teach them to scrub and to do a complete cleaning. And I wonder if sometimes we don't treat the Word that way, that we're not in it long enough to truly get clean, and we're not in it and doing anything productive as far as asking the Holy Spirit to lead us and guide us. We're not digging in it. We're not really being washed by it when we're in it. And so my question to you is, are you in it enough, and are you in it in a manner to actually be clean? And then ask yourselves as a group tonight, what changes need to happen as I approach the Word? If I really want to be continually cleaned and prepared for more intimacy with Christ, what needs to change today and in this next week before we meet again? So just want to lay that on your plate today for consideration. And you guys just think about that and talk about that in your small groups. I'll see you next week. And I'll